the creation story and the erection of the tabernacle. Genesis 1 and Exodus 40 compared. Part 2b, the creation of male and female. So God created man in his own image, male and female he created them. In the previous video we established a link between the Trinity and the Ark of the Covenant. Yet tradition describes one cherub as being male, and the other being female. So where is the female symbolism in God? Ancient Christians describe the Holy Spirit coming on Christ as being his mother. But because the word Spirit is not feminine in Greek or Latin, this understanding was largely forgotten. However, one word which is feminine in Hebrew, Greek, and Latin is wisdom, like the name Sophia. And it is the female Lady Wisdom who enters holy souls and makes them friends of God, and prophets. Holy Old Testament women and men. However, Christ is also called the Wisdom of God, so another female symbol is obscured. The term church is, however, given female symbols in the Bible, our mother, wife of Christ. Yet no church building can claim to be specifically female. Also, some claim that the church cannot be called a building but is in fact just a group of people. Don't just come to church, become the church. The church is not a building where we gather. The church is the people who gather in Christ's name. The church is a body that just happens to meet in a building. Then again, a group of mixed people can hardly be described as female either. Yet the book of Revelation describes a female figure. She is clothed with the sun. She has the moon under her feet. She has 12 stars in her crown. The events depicted are as follows. Christ her son is taken up to heaven. The dragon vomits water to attack the woman, but the earth drinks it. The woman is given wings to help her escape. The dragon then goes to fight her other children. Her identity as the church can be seen by comparing her description to Solomon's temple. She is clothed with the sun. This would be the gold which covered the temple interior. She has the moon under her feet. This would be the water in the bronze basin. She has 12 stars in her crown. These are the 10 lampstands with the menorah and bronze serpent. The symbolism of a dragon vomiting water would have come from the seven-headed serpent fountain. See the video The Dragon Leviathan and Behemoth Explained. Yet the church is also called the body of Christ, with Christ as the head. So it would appear that another divine female symbol has been obscured by the male Christ. However, Saint Clement of Rome, the fourth pope, clearly had a very different understanding of this. When the Bible says, God created man male and female, the male refers to Christ and the female to the church. Both Christ and the church are therefore from the beginning. So the church cannot be a group of people. The church was made manifest in the flesh of Christ. So Christ is actually now both male and female. So the church keeps her female symbolism. However, I know of no picture of Christ or the church like this, so where is the female symbolism of God? Byzantine-style churches are usually covered with images of the saints. And there is one special saint who is always opposite Christ. And this special saint is the Virgin Mary, whose image represents the Church, the female aspect of God. Well, spiffing. She is alone of all her sex. Mary is too pure for us. She makes sex seem sinful. Her submission is a bad role model. Christ needs no mediator. She is not the Immaculate Conception. Her tenderness is a cover for guilt. She is not a co-redemptrix. In the West, over the past 1,000 years, there have been certain developments which give rise to such justified objections. However, they will need to be examined later. Please see www.rwtheology.org/the-goddess.html. Thank you for watching. The connection between the creation story and tabernacle temple symbolism is continued at www.rwtheology.org/creation-stories.html. However, as just mentioned, further thoughts on the implications for the Virgin Mary being the symbol of the divine female are to be found at www.rwtheology.org/the-goddess.html.